Nearly everything I've said so far is wrong, according to at least one tax treaty. Treaties are agreements between national governments and can modify the law of the signatory countries. And our tax treaties do just that. Sometimes, though, our law modifies the treaties. Here are the two most important things you need to know about treaties. First, every treaty is different. No two are alike. They may have a lot of things in common, but no two are alike. Second, treaties do not cause tax. They only reduce tax. Some of the things commonly in treaties are shown here. Often, withholding on interest and royalties is reduced to zero. The withholding rate on dividends varies, depending on whether the shareholder is an individual or a corporation, and on the level of ownership. Treaties almost always limit a country's ability to tax the resident of the other country on business income. To be taxable, the income needs to be effectively connected with a permanent establishment in the taxing country.
Our local partner told me about how we can ship the profits offshore to a trading company.
The IRS has tools to fight this tactic and has a good success record. These are the transfer pricing rules. They've been around since the 1930s. The regulations have been expanded a lot in the last 20 years, though. Here are the rules in a nutshell. Profits must follow functions and risks. Charges for services must be for services actually benefiting the company getting charged. Taxpayers can do analyses to determine whether, under one of the applicable testing methods, the prices are within an arm's length range. If they don't, there's no penalty unless the IRS makes an adjustment. Then, if the adjustment is above certain thresholds, the IRS can assess a penalty based on the increase in tax, unless the taxpayer has done a transfer pricing study. IRS rules predate the OECD rules. The current OECD rules are very similar to IRS rules. So let's recap what we've learned. First, all the regular rules apply. Citizens and residents, including individuals living in the USA and corporations incorporated in the USA, pay U.S. income tax on their worldwide income. These citizens and residents get a credit for foreign income tax paid. The credit is limited to the part of federal income tax caused by foreign source taxable income. Source rules apply to determine what income is foreign and what is from U.S. sources. Deductions must be allocated and apportioned to determine the net taxable income from each source. The deduction and source rules apply for both inbound and outbound. Non-residents pay U.S. tax at regular rates on taxable income from a trade or business and on wages. Non-residents are subject to a flat 30% tax that is withheld from some other kinds of U.S. income. This tax may be reduced under a tax treaty. American expats get to exclude income if they meet the physical presence and bona fide resident tests. And citizens and residents may be subject to subpart F or PFIC provisions that limit their ability to defer income related to their investment in foreign corporations. This is pretty complex stuff. This overview is designed to give you a basic idea of what U.S. international tax rules do. I hope you found this useful, and thanks for learning with me.